Jesus' name.
Amen.
Why sister, then please open with me to James chapter 1, and together we will read verse 19 and 20. James chapter 1, and together we will read verse 19 and 20. Wherefore, my beloved brethren, let every man be swift to hear, slow to speak, slow to wrath. For the wrath of man worketh not the righteousness of God. To go into the concluding part of the sermon, anger is madness. Let's sing the song, Ancient of Days, as old as you are.
Ancient of Days, as old as you are.
Thank you. What is going on? Explain what is going on. Sending you that I am not a member of the day. I go to leaders' chapel. But this day, that was last Sunday, something just told me to come here. I don't go to redeem. But something just said come here. And I came. And you were talking about me. Because I have perfected plans to kill my father tomorrow. So what happened? She said, Pastor, she was already crying. I have found out where my father is. They told me where he is, and I decided tomorrow he will die. So I don't know, maybe he's going to be the hired assassin or whatever, but she said she's 28 years old. And she had not seen her father with her eyes at the age of 28. So much anger has welled up inside her. She said, Pastor, in fact, I sent him a text a few days ago and I said to him, as far as I am concerned, you are a dead man. And she was going to carry out the murder following him. Somehow, she ended up in church. And she listened to the sermon, anger is madness. And that's how the life of that man was saved. If that man would have been killed by now, the man would have been killed by now. But thank God, somebody heard the word of God and decided to surrender. I pray for you from the bottom of my heart. Every evil that the enemy wants to do through you with anger, that evil is terminated right now in the mighty name of Jesus. And every one that the enemy is trying to use through anger to destroy your life, the enemy has already entered into them and they have decided out of anger to destroy you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, the arrester of the arrestor, every one of them is arrested right now in Jesus' name. Yeah. Some of you may say, but Pastor, when I am angry, I don't kill. So this sermon doesn't apply to me. When I get angry, but I don't kill. Say who? Do you have to stab somebody before you kill? Do you have to shoot somebody before you kill? Your mouth alone can kill somebody. That's why I decided that we should go to part two. I struggled during the week. Why don't I just read it as part one? I think the message is already clear. But my screen did not allow me to rest. It's going to be take it a little further. That's why, as God listening to me, I want to conclude on how are the other ways anger can manifest when it is complete. When the anger starts, by the time it finishes, what are the other ways that it manifests? Last Sunday, I showed you one way it manifests in death. And I showed you the examples of many people that died because somebody crossed and today I will share with you seven more points as God has laid in my heart. How anger can manifest when it has matured. Number one, it manifests in broken marriages. Broken marriages. Pastor, I don't kill when I'm angry. It's true, you don't kill. But anger can manifest in another way by destroying your marriage. I shared during the first service. Somebody woke up one day after 47 years of marriage, 40-something years of marriage. I said, that I have discovered I can't live with this person. After how many years? for more than 40 years, you are now just discovering. That's why they say anger is madness. How old are you anyway? Maybe you are now 70 something years old. You have only that many more years to live. And then anger is telling you that the person you have lived with for 40 something years, you can no longer live with the person anymore. That's why anger is called madness. And there are examples of 60-year-old people, 70-year-old people divorcing. Because at the point of anger, they are simply mad. The same thing happens even to young couples. You marry a few months, and before you know it, the simple anger says, no, I'm not doing anymore. I pray for you from the bottom of my heart. Every marriage that anger has destroyed, in the mighty name of Jesus, it is restored in Jesus' name.
Amen.
If you are one of those whose marriages have been destroyed, pray carefully, call your partner. Pray carefully, call your partner. After this sermon, after you get home, pray carefully. If that marriage is already destroyed, I know it is restored in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
And Holy Spirit will speak to you, and that marriage will be returned to the will of God in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Second way you can manifest. Broken families. Broken families. Little anger. Our brothers and sisters born of the same father. Raised in the same home, we all of a sudden decided, no, we can't get along. And because of that, for many, many, many years to come, they will not talk to anyone. Because of one simple anger. Can I share with you a personal private example? Yesterday, I sent to my brothers and sisters, my own brothers, blood brothers and sisters, some photographs. Because also last Sunday, another person came after service, after the second, and said, Pastor, I want to see you. What is the problem? And I said, pray for me. My family is scattered. Again, another person came after last Sunday. The family broken apart because of anger. And the way I prayed for her, I said, my sister, the same God that healed my own family, that same God will settle your own matter.
Yes.
That was my prayer for her. Because I know also the family from where I came, my own brothers and sisters, for many, many years, everyone was on his own. My brother was flying in from America to come to Nigeria and go. I'll be hearing from people. You know that my brother was like that. My own blood brother will come to Nigeria from outside Nigeria. Do everything they want to do and you will go. I'll be hearing from people. Ah, we saw your brother. And maybe another one will come. That was my elder brother. He will come and another one will come. And then he will live with anybody but me. He will live with anybody but no, he will not live with any brother, he will not live with any sister. He stays also outside Nigeria. He stays outside Nigeria. There are some of us who are based in Nigeria, about three of them also are based outside Nigeria. This one too will come to Nigeria. And he will make sure he does not stay in any of our houses. He prefers to stay with foreigners. The strangers that stay with his own daughter. That was the situation of my family until about a year or two ago. And I decided, and God decided for us, that it's time to find God. So yesterday, programs that I had in 2013. And I said it to them, please listen, this is a real life story. I said, November 2013, see what our family house looked like in Jebu, Russia. I showed them those photographs. I don't know whether I should show you, but then let me describe. I showed them those photographs. By that time, because we were disunited, everything was a sham, even though we were trained properly by our parents. That's why I said, anger destroys. Nobody was paying attention anymore. Everybody was on his own. The house our father built became a shambles. The roof had collapsed. The walls had broken down. People could not even live inside it anymore because the roof has fallen off. The walls have removed. They took pan, this is pan, they call it aluminium, and use it to just pack some wall. If they show you and say this is Pastor's father's house, you will never, never believe. But it happened because nobody will cooperate to do anything. So I said to them yesterday, look at what the house looked like in 2013. And then I sent them another photograph. Look at what it looks like today in March 2016. I said, this is what unity can achieve. When we decided to forget about anger and love one another, see what the house now looks like. The person who had money brought money. The person who doesn't have money said, okay, don't worry, I don't have money, but I will go to the place. And then he wants to advise the carpenter, everybody brought what they had. Today, that house with broken roof, with thatched, everything is now the best house in the village. That is what unity can do. The exact opposite is what anger can do. It will destroy everything. I pray for broken homes today. Every family that anger has destroyed, the God of peace, the Prince of peace, will enter those homes in the mighty name of Jesus. He will enter those families in the mighty name of Jesus. Everything that anger has damaged in your family, from the root of that anger, I uproot it in the mighty name of Jesus. Manifestation number three. Broken relationships. Oh, a friend that you went to school together. You've been together for many, many years. Why anger? Why? Those two. Why? And that relationship terminates. A relationship built over years and decades. With one anger, that relationship comes to an end. Manifestation number four. Broken career. Broken career. When the enemy manages to enter you and gets you angry, it can manifest in a broken career. And I'll share two examples with you. A member of this church about 3 years ago called me during the government office hours. Pastor, I just want you to know, Pastor, I'm not notifying you. I am not asking for permission. I'm notifying you, Pastor. I am resigning today from my office.
Calm down.
Pastor, I'm not sending you. But calm down. I'm not telling you, Pastor. This place I'm working, I have had enough, I'm resigning now. I just want to tell you before I tell you that, calm down. No, I'm leaving. I said, okay, let me ask you a question. Do you have another job? Say, no, I don't have another job yet, but I'm leaving. No, I said, anger is.
I'm sorry, but I didn't and your sons and your daughter's school fees become due. That's when you will know that right now you are mad. But you will get angry and resign, and then they will send you the school fees. Tell me what will be your answer. You send to the school, sorry, I can't pay because. And that sweet heart of yours that had been nice because you had a job. You just want to resign anyhow. You will see a new side of that your sweetheart. You will come home, nobody will answer the door. Nobody will answer the door. That's when you will know that you are my own personal example. In 2009, I was temporarily mad. Temporarily. I got up and I said, I'm very angry. I'm very, very angry with this company. Working with Mobi. You are working with Mobi producing and you are angry, yes. I'm angry with this company. There are many people who are trying to get inside. And you are saying you want to go outside. So yes, I'm leaving. So I went to, and I was a manager at that point, right? So I went to an air contact man, and many of us know here, they recruit senior people. I said, I'm leaving. I want to interview for another job. But somehow, God has seen me that this man is temporarily man. So he positioned somebody there who has common sense. So when I saw the man, as I have come to look for job, I'm resigning. I said, what's the problem? He said, that company. It's not that company. It's not that. Oh, that company. I'm leaving that company. So I went on and on and on and I said, okay. With your experience and qualification, it won't take us longer at all to get to any job. You want to become CFO, you want to, you can get to the job like that very quickly. Say, but can I talk to you? I want another job. Say, can I talk to you? And because it was older than me, so I said, okay. But this is not what I think. And then he talked to me. So I sat down and he said, let me talk to you about my career. He went on and on. I used to be managing director of the bank. Went on and on and on and on and on. Told me his story. How I've been the managing director of the bank. See where he is right now. And so on. I said, but this is not why. Okay. I see what this man is saying. Right. After that, he shared the example of the MD of that company. He said, see, the MD of this company that you have come to look for job. That man wanted to resign many years ago, but he chose not to. And today, he is a manager of the company. So, Sheldon, that's what he said to me. You choose what you want, and he's a Muslim. That's not a Christian. But God had positioned somebody for me in my hour of need. If that man was not there that day, I would have damaged my career. I pray for you from the bottom of my heart. In the day that you need help urgently, God will position an angel for you in the mighty name of Jesus. Don't worry, things will get better. By that time, my madness will come down right now in the mighty name of Jesus.
So very grudgingly, this man is not allowed to step back. I went back to the office. A few months later, announcement was released by the company. Chairman Bao appointed General Manager Brian.
Just like that?
But if I had let, in anger, somebody else would be sitting in that position. That was 2009, late 2009. February 2011, another announcement released by the company. Chairman Bao appointed financial controller. Just like that. March the following year, Chairman Bao appointed executive director. What would have happened if that man was